Hello viewers, welcome to the course on Fundamentals of Horticulture. Today we will discuss about introductory knowledge of main branches of horticulture and their importance. The term horticulture was first used in 16th century. This term is derived of two Latin words named hortus, meaning garden or enclosure, and cultura, meaning cultivation. Horticulture literally means cultivated garden or culture of gardens. The term agriculture refers broadly to the technology of raising plants and animals. On the other hand, the term horticulture, which is a part of agriculture, is concerned with the raising of so-called garden crops. At present, fruits, vegetables, flowers, etc. are grown not only within the backyards but also in large areas in open fields on a commercial scale. Traditionally, garden crops include fruits, vegetables, and flowers. But today's horticulture deals not only the fruits, vegetables and flowers, but also other important crops like spices, condiments, plantation crops, medicinal and aromatic plants, etc. Presently, the horticulture is not only limited to the backyard cultivation of fruits and vegetables, but it has grown very largely to the commercial scale also. Besides cultivation of these crops, present day horticulture also deals with the utilization and improvement of these crops. Hence, we can define modern horticulture as a part of agriculture science, which deals with the production, utilization, and improvement of fruits, vegetables, flowers, ornamental, plantation crops, medicinal, and aromatic plants, etc. The Government of India also emphasizing horticulture in a great way. In 2005-06, during 10th plan period, the government has initiated a national horticulture mission, which is a national plan to improve the horticulture crops in the country. The NHM's key objective is to develop horticulture to the maximum potential available and to augment production of all horticultural products, like fruits, vegetables, flowers, plantation crops, spices, medicinal, etc. That is, the holistic growth of the horticulture sector is the main objective of National Horticulture Mission. Importance of horticulture. The first part is per unit area yield is high. As compared to the field crops, per hectare yield of horticulture crops is very high. From an fruit area of land, more yield is obtained. For example, paddy gives a maximum yield of only 30 quintals per hectare, while banana gives 300 to 500 quintals per hectare. Pineapple 450 quintals per hectare and grapes 90 to 150 quintals per hectare. In present shortage of food and scarcity of land, by growing fruits, more food can be produced. So the first part, the importance of horticulture, we can say it gives more yield per unit area as compared to the other crops. The second importance is high returns per unit area. From one unit area of land, more income will be obtained. For example, well-kept orchard of apple, grapes and sweet orange can give as much as rupees 25,000 per hectare as net income. Best utilization of wasteland is the another importance of horticulture. Some fruit crops can offer best utilization of wasteland crops like wood apple, custard apple, karanda, lychee, etc., which can be grown in such areas. By choosing horticulture crops, we can also use the lands which are waste in present situation. So we can improve our food productivity in such way. Free grower labor remains engaged for the whole. An opportunity for maintaining labors throughout the year, like the cereals, where one cannot keep himself and employ the labors during the slack season. Another important point is raw material for industries. Fruit farming is the base for several industries like canning, essential oils, etc., which in turn provide work for more people. With this horticulture sector, we can provide all the year-round employment to our labors, and also it supplies raw material to the many industries. To meet the annual calories requirement of food per year, one would have to cultivate about 0.58 hectare of wheat or 0.03 hectare of banana or 0.06 hectare of mango for satisfying one's need. Thus, mango produces about 9 times more food energy than the wheat produced per unit area. So we can see that in terms of food calories, the horticultural crops gives more calorie per unit area than the other agricultural crops. Another importance of horticulture is use of undulating lands. Fruit growing can be practiced in places where the gradient is uneven or where the land is undulating and agronomical crops cannot be cultivated. Like in Konkan region, mango and cashew are cultivated on large scale on hilly and hillback area. Fruits and vegetables are the important energy giving material to the human body. Now, let us discuss the branches of horticulture. Horticulture crops include fruits, vegetables, flowers, plantation crops, spices, condiments, medicinal and aromatic crops, etc. In addition to these, horticulture also deals with raising of trees for shade, ornamental and avenue purposes. Planning and raising of ornamental gardens, parks, and raising of seed and planting material. Further, horticulture also deals with the utilization of horticulture produce and improvement of horticulture crops. So, horticulture has a very huge area of uses, like ornamental gardens to the commercial flowering or the commercial fruit production. Hence, based upon the crops dealt and also their purpose and utilization, the branch of horticulture is subdivided into the following divisions for convenience. The first branch is pomology. It is derived from two words, that is pomum meaning fruit and logos meaning discourse or study. So pomology is study or cultivation of fruit crops, for example mango, sapota, guava, grapes, banana, etc. And we can define fruit as it is a developed and matured ovary with or without accessory parts and which is generally eaten as raw. So we can say that the branch which deals with the cultivation of fruits is called pomology. Olericulture. It is derived from two words, that is oleris meaning pot herb and cultura meaning cultivation. So olericulture literally means pot herb cultivation. In the present days, it is broadly used to indicate the cultivation of vegetables. For example, brinjal, okra, tomato, pumpkin, etc. And we can define vegetable as it is any part of the herbaceous plant that is generally used after cooking as a principal part of the meal. So we can say that olericulture is the branch of horticulture which deals with the cultivation of vegetables. Floriculture. It is derived from two words, that is florus meaning flower and cultura meaning cultivation. So floriculture means study of flower crops. In this, there are again two subdivisions. First one is commercial floriculture. Deals with the cultivation of flower crops grown on commercial scale for profit. Example is rose, jasmine, carnation, aster and marigold. Second one is ornamental floriculture. It deals with the raising of flower crops for ornamental pleasure and fashion purpose. For example, dahlia, zinnia, cosmos, hibiscus, balsam, nerium, poinsettia, hollyhock, gerbera, giardia. These are the flowering plants which are grown for the ornamental purpose. Arboriculture. This branch of horticulture deals with the raising of perennial trees meant for shade, avenue or ornamental purposes. The examples are Polilithia, Spathodia, Acacia, Gulmohar, etc. So the branch of horticulture which deals with the growing of trees for ornamental purpose is called arboriculture. As you can see in this picture, there are four types of perennial trees used as a ornamental plant are shown in this picture. The first one is Polilithia longifolia, commonly also called as Ashok, and the other three varieties are the various colors of Gulmohar trees. The plantation crops are those crops which are cultivated in an extensive scale in large contiguous areas, owned and managed by an individual or a company, and whose produce is utilized only after processing. Examples are coffee, tea, rubber, coconut, coca, etc. Post-harvest technology. It deals with the processing and preservation of produce of horticulture crops like jam, jelly, pickles, sauce, juice, candy, etc. Landscape gardening. Landscape gardening deals with the planning and execution of ornamental gardens, parks, landscape gardens, etc. You can see in this picture a very beautiful scene of landscape gardening showing various colors of flowers, perennial trees and other ornamental bushes. Now let us discuss about the spices and condiments. This branch deals with the cultivation of crops whose produce is used mainly for seasoning and flavoring the dishes. Spices are those plants the products of which are made use of as food adjuncts to add aroma and flavor. The examples are pepper, cardamom, clove, cinnamon, etc. Condiments are those plants the products of which are made use of as food adjuncts to add taste only. Examples are turmeric, ginger, red chilies, onion, garlic, etc. Both spices and condiments contain essential oils which provide aroma, flavor, and taste, and they are of little nutritive value. Horticulture also deals with the plants like spices and condiments, and they are mainly used to flavor the dishes and have a less nutritive value. Medicinal and aromatic plants. It deals with the cultivation of medicinal plants which provide drugs and aromatic crops which yields aromatic, that is essential oils. Medicinal plants are those plants which are rich in secondary metabolites and are potential sources of drugs. The secondary metabolites include alkaloids, glycosides, cumarins, flavonoids and steroids, etc. Examples of medicinal plants are periwinkle, opium, menthi, cinchona, diascora, yam, belladonna, senna, sarpganda, ashwagandha, tulsi, etc. Among the medicinal plants, senna Tulsi, Ashwagandha, Sharpgandha are very common names. Many peoples may be knowing about their properties and their uses. You can see in this picture that a children is nurturing the traditional medicinal plant that is Tulsi. Aromatic plants are those plants which possesses essential oils in them. The essential oils are the odoriferous steam volatile constituents of aromatic plants. The examples are lemongrass, citronella, palm rosa, vetiver, geranium, davanum, lavender, etc. The another important branch is nursery and seed production. It deals with the production of seeds and planting material of horticulture crops on commercial basis. Plants grown for aesthetic value are also included in horticulture. Now let us see the role of horticulture crops in human nutrition. From human nutrition point of view, horticulture is most important to our daily living. Many of the horticulture crops and their products find place in our meals and diet. Human body requires vitamins, minerals, proteins, energy, etc. for its health. Fruits and vegetables are the chief source of vitamins, minerals, carbohydrates, fats, proteins, etc., thus recognized as protective foods, as they are necessary for the maintenance of human health. The produce of horticulture sector are also called as protective foods because they are required or necessary for the maintenance of human body. Vitamins. The horticulture produce also provides vitamins to the human body. These are the important constituents of fruits and vegetables and are indispensable part of human diet. Although required in very minute quantities, they are absolutely essential for the maintenance of health. The deficiency of any vitamin from the diet for considerable period may lead to diseased state or disorder conditions. Fruits and vegetables supply several vitamins. Among them, vitamin A, B, C, D are the common names. Iron. It is required for production of hemoglobin and it is constituent of red blood corpuscles. Its deficiency causes anemia, smooth tongue, pale lips, eyes and skin and frequent exhaustion. The sources of iron are among fruits, custard apples, guava, pineapple, strawberry, grape, black currants, dried dates, etc. and among vegetables, carrot, beans, etc. Proteins. These are essential for growth of the body. The deficiency of proteins in the body causes retarded growth and increases susceptibility to diseases and causes lethargy. Most of the fruits are low in proteins except guava, banana and nuts. Vegetables like peas and beans are rich in proteins. The importance of horticulture in the national economy. India ranks second in fruits and vegetable production in the world after China. India in 2012 produced fruits 76.42 million metric tons and 156.33 million metric tons of vegetables. The area under cultivation of fruits stood at 6.70 million hectares, while vegetables were cultivated at 8.99 million hectares. Globally, we are second largest producer of fruits and vegetables. Largest producer of mango, banana, coconut, cashew, papaya, pomegranate, etc. Largest producer and exporter of spices, ranks first in productivity of grapes, banana, cassava, peas, papaya, etc. During 2012-13, India exported fruits and vegetables worth rupees 5,986.72 crores, which comprised of fruits worth rupees 2,503.75 crores and vegetables worth rupees 3,482.97 crores. In the case of fruits, the per capita availability increased from 114 grams per day in 2001-2 to 172 grams per day in 2011-12. Similarly, the per capita availability of vegetables increased from 236 grams per day to 350 grams per day during this period. So we have seen that in India, the horticulture sector has grown tremendously, and it is visible from the per capita availability of fruits and vegetables. Dear viewers, in today's course, we have discussed about the importance of horticulture, that how it gives all the year round employment to our labors, how it gives the raw material supply to our industries. We also discussed about the various branches of horticulture, that is the like pomology, which deals with the cultivation of fruits, like olericulture, which deals with the cultivation of vegetables, floriculture, the other branches of floriculture, the cultivation of medicinal and aromatic plants, etc. We have also seen the state of horticulture in our country, that how we are doing export of horticulture produce, how we are getting foreign exchange by exporting the horticulture produce, that we are also second largest producer of fruits and vegetables in the world after China.